This is Star Wars The Black Series from Hasbro, and this figure is Darth Vader Duel's End, which is basically Darth Vader from the Kenobi TV show. And this is what we've got, and it's there's parts of this that are really, really good. Very impressed with this. Let's look at the packaging first and foremost, get that out of the way. Star Wars The Black Series, with the blue strip there for Kenobi. Duel's End, as I mentioned. And we get some very nice artwork on the side of the packaging. Really, really nice, showing that exposed piece there for Anakin underneath. This is an exclusive figure for some regions, so you may find it in different places around the world. And on the back, it is number 15 in the line. And if we just want to freeze frame, you can read that in English there. It'll tell you nothing you probably didn't know already. Again, just that product shot on the side there of the artwork, looking very, very creepy. In terms of the UPC for this figure, if that is helpful to you, it is there. And that's it. Star Wars The Black Series on the side, and just the usual classic window box style that we're going back to. So let's get straight into the meat and potatoes here. The most exciting part of the figure is here. It is the facial sculpt, the piece where obviously Anakin is underneath, and it looks fantastic. They really seem to have captured well Hayden Christensen inside this helmet, and it looks like they've almost kind of finalized a little bit more than the gap shows, which is nice. It's really obviously hard to get in there, and it's very sharp, but it really kind of shows you that they've basically done a full head on this and then added the helmet thereafter. But it is beautifully done. The eye is gorgeous. It's got that kind of rage going on. This is where the money has went. All around though, that eye, the red, purple kind of swollenness around his eye. And then the scars on the side of the face too. Let me see if I can just part it a little bit. You can see some of the veins on his head. It just keeps wanting to spring back, obviously. Can just see the love and attention that they've put into this, and particularly as we know from Empire Strikes Back sequence, in the asteroid belt, we know that Vader's head is mutilated, particularly at the back. But the use of the paint here, the eye itself, is just pretty incredible. Let me see if I can really just bring that up a little bit closer for you without going out of focus, just to kind of show you the real value here for this figure. So it's really well done. The damage around the area on the helmet is superb too. It's really captured a nice melty plastic vibe going on, and it's kind of seared down into the underside of the under helmet kind of piece there, as you can see. Kind of split level, so there's a kind of protective layer around more the kind of grill piece, and then this larger kind of piece that Vader's helmet forms. But it's very nice indeed. So here we are going out on veins and damage, but this is the key point in this figure. It is exceptionally good, and it really captures, I think, Christian Hayden and the character he plays really, really well. So that's the money shot. That's the real key part of this figure. So let's pull back and get a look at the rest of it, because there are some other parts and pieces. One of the other areas where you can really see destruction on the figure is around the chest plate, and you can see the damage where two lightsaber blasts have kind of, or slices have kind of smeared off controls and turned off controls. And there's a little bit of I thought that was paint, it's more the reflection. Yeah, it is. That is principally the key part on this Vader, and the rest of it is pretty much like a lot of Vaders. Now, I'm no Vader expert. There has been minute versions with real minutiae changed on it over time. But a lot of Vader fans will say, that's a different one. Yes, I get it, but not everybody knows. What we do get here is the very kind of Episode 4 red lens Vader, which this is one of the more recent ones. I can't recall if it's 40th anniversary or one that came in the angled box, but you can see there obviously it got darker over time. We got a different helmet shape from the kind of slightly larger one that we had in the past. I think this is one of the more recent kind of Empire Strikes Back versions that we got over the years. There's so many Vaders, it's kind of ridiculously hard to remember them all. Or I certainly don't. The subtle changes on the control panel, you can see what was and what is now different because it's been slashed across. And it looks to be that they are using the same belt. Why wouldn't they? The same cod piece, the same parts, the rest of it around the figure. In terms of the lightsaber, it also appears to be the same. I don't see any major difference on this. I'm just looking a little bit closer. Not really new. Seems to be the same length. Slightly different than newer one. Seems much more solid red, but it seems to be the same saber. Minuscule differences. Other than that, same Vader than we've had recently. I think that Empire Strikes Back one is the version that is used here. Still got pins on the legs, but we do get this version using the same as before, so there's no pins on the arms on that single joint. In terms of Vader and his posability, look, it's not too shabby considering he's been sliced open and he's got all this armor on. The head is quite maneuverable. It is not, you cannot take the helmet off as such. It would have been great to do that, but I'm sure someone's going to do that, but I'm not. But it looks really, really good. So plenty of rotation and movement. No major kind of articulation there, but it's still pretty good. It's still pretty good for this figure overall. Ball joint up at the top of the shoulder, which I don't think it was a butterfly joint in there. Might be. Maybe a little tiny one. It might be actually. But a single joint at the elbows, which gives you a pretty reasonable range of motion for them. It's not too bad. And both swivel and back and forth. There's up and down in this hand. It's up and down. In terms of his waist articulation, that's where the cloth kind of tucks inside. And of course, it makes it a little bit harder to move around with that cloth cape there, which is kind of woven underneath the figure. So don't get too creative with your posing. But you do get that waist articulation there and a bit of a kind of ab crunch of sorts. Up at the top of the legs, you can see the pins that hold him in place, and I think this is this one of the pull-down hips. No, it is not. So pegs up at the top of the legs. We've got a thigh swivel and a double joint at the knees, tucked away in those boots, and down to rocking ankles and peg holes. And it's just overall, it's a really nice excuse to get another Vader out there with this helmet on. And I think a lot of people will love it. It is quite outstanding, that head that he's got on him. And it just looks really good. The head is, let me kind of see if I can bring this closer together a little bit. Move this down a little bit. In terms of the size of the helmet, it feels a little bigger. Looks it. So it looks to be that they've used the original larger size scale of helmet. Either way, I think they've obviously had to do a unique helmet here for this piece or retool something from the past. Lots of Vader experts, I'm sure, will dive in and explain the differences here. But you can obviously see this one's a little bit more squat and short than this older style that he had, and it's all slightly changed throughout each movie. So there you go. Not much else I can tell you on that. Is a pretty solid figure in terms of scale and size. He's no different to previous Vaders. Let me just give you a size just for completeness. We've got a Vader head to toe. We're coming in at just under 7 inches or 17 centimeters, roughly 6 3/4 inches. So he's a big chappy, and that is Vader from the Kenobi series. Hope that was useful in your buying decisions, and we will see you for more. Cheers.